submit. You gotta submit. You gotta submit.
Welcome to the Nathaniel Noble Jr. Podcast, where we talk about life because it happens to everyone, along with some great indie musicians' Q&A sessions. So come aboard, kick back, and let's vibe.
Nathaniel Noble Jr. Podcast.
You gotta submit. Welcome this week's guest on the Nathaniel Noble Jr. Podcast, a young lady I met at LA foodie event out in Pasadena. As I was walking and finishing up my walk, I met her and her girlfriend walking to the foodie event. And you know me, I'm just saying, hi, how you doing? I'm speaking. I was in a speaking mode that day and they spoke back and we ended up chit-chatting on the way to the foodie and ended up exchanging business cards. She does a podcast called The Kindness Tours, and I do my podcast, which you're listening to now, and I say we need to just do a swap. You come on my show, I come on your show. Mm-hmm. All right, so yeah. So yesterday, her and her girlfriend came out and interviewed me for their show, and she's on my show today. So welcome to the show, Miss Pilar. Hey.
Yes, yay. Thank you, Nate. Thank you. I'm glad to be here. Thanks so much for inviting me.
Yeah, thanks for coming
and
on.
And thank you again for yesterday for being on my show. I really appreciate it. Really grateful. Thank you.
Good. I hope you got some great content that you can use to help the people that listen.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So tell us.
Absolutely, we do.
Tell us your mm-hmm. story. Where you going? Where you been and where you coming from? All that stuff, you know. Who are you and
all that good stuff, yeah. Right?
Give us all the good stuff we need to know.
Right. Okay. Well, Kindness Tours, as you just mentioned, my podcast, or I should say organization, is called Kindness Tours. We do the podcast as well as we do giveaways to companies, essential workers. It started in the pandemic, so we started out with doing a lot of essential workers showing up, giving them lunch for the day. We did the fire department, giving them either lunch, breakfast, snacks, whatever it is, just to, you know, to uplift and inspire and encourage. That's what Kindness Tours is about. And the podcast is about healing. It's called Being Heard, Being Healed. And then sometimes the best way to heal someone, if someone gets healed, is to just sit and listen. You don't have to do a whole lot. Just listen. And a lot of healing will take place. So we have that on the Kindness Tours, our website, and on our channel. The Being Heard, Being Healed section of it. And so we have a lot of interviews and sit downs with people. And your sit down was awesome. So awesome yesterday. And so that's going to help people heal going through the same experiences that you have and that you did at one time.
Oh, yeah, that was rough.
Mm-hmm.
But here we stand today with a testimony of overcoming.
Mm-hmm.
But I wouldn't
overcoming,
wish it on,
going through.
I wouldn't wish yes. it on nobody.
Nope. But that's how you evolve.
Yes.
And this is how you get better, is going through it and not going over it or around it. Mm-hmm. You have to go through it, that word through. And most people don't do that.
Yeah.
No, most people don't look at their pain in the eyes and sit in it and feel it.
Mm.
So it starts to go away. So when you feel it, that's when you're getting through it. But when you start avoiding it because it hurts too bad and doing all other things and all types of stuff to avoid that pain, that's when a mistake happens, because it catches up with you and bites you in the butt later. And everybody else in the butt later too, that you're dealing with, because hurt people, right?
Mm-hmm.
They project. So.
Yeah, I didn't want to be that guy.
Nope.
I wanted to come out healed and help healed.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And that's, you know, and that's the reason, one of the reasons I think that we bumped into each other, very purposeful. You know, it's because the divine knows, God knows that you have a story that can heal someone that has gone through the same thing. And for whatever reason, we may or may not ever know that it was supposed to come out that way on Being Heard, Being Healed and Kindness Tours. So I'm grateful for it.
Yeah, I don't have a problem sharing my story and my pain. I guess one of the worst times in my life. So I don't have a problem sharing it because I guess it's just a story of overcoming and pressing through.
Yes.
So, yes. Yeah. If it can help somebody, give it up. Give it to them.
Yeah, and that's important.
So you interviewed certain people and let me see, what else? You say you give away stuff and what's the next move? What's the, I guess.
And we do a, we also do the one to grow on. And our goal, we're expanding and we're doing tours and basically a kindness tour. Once we get everybody involved, is we want to go on tours. We are going on tours. So basically what you do is instead of just myself going out to from company to company to company, giving out gifts or giving random people gifts, it would be our tour bus. When you see our logo is a little bus. So to do tours. So we're people are going to pay a fee to come with us on a tour. And the fee basically just goes towards your lunch and the gas. And you choose a gift or something that you want to give out to the public. It will be yours and it'll be from you. So it could be anything. It could be your guitar or, you know, you want to buy something, some socks or something. I don't know. Whatever it is, whatever you're giving from your heart, you will bring that with you. We're all on the bus with the things that we want to give out. And we're going to go choose a city to go to. So let's just say we're going to choose Culver City here in LA or anywhere, Sedona. That's what these tours are. That's how we're going to expand. We want to expand wide instead of just doing LA County here, you know, where I reside. We do travel to San Diego. Okay, we're doing a tour to San Diego today. We have a busload of people that's in a giving spirit that want to uplift people and encourage them and inspire them. And we're going to San Diego to do this. So whatever you want to bring with you to uplift society, then you bring it with you. And then the bus is on and then it's on. So that's what we're heading next. And that's as we speak, planning that. So
awesome.
We're going to get everybody involved because people want to give. Yeah. A lot of people do want to give and want, and you know, sometimes they need that push or a platform to give and they won't, you know, create something on their own. That's okay too. But, you know, to have a platform to give, you know, it's great. It's easier for people. They're like, oh, sure. I would love to do this. You know, I would love to give somebody something for the day or inspire somebody or uplift somebody's spirit. Cause people, you know, are most people right now are struggling.
Yeah.
Right now, emotionally.
Yeah.
So
a lot of them probably won't tell you and stuff, but yeah, they secretly in the struggle and depression.
Absolutely.
Depression is real.
Absolutely. Very real. Very real. And I know I experienced that at some point in my life as well.
Yeah. Been there, done that. Got the pain to prove it. But yeah, so yeah, anything uplifting and encouraging, and so and I do a lot of that too. So I guess I'd be on a kindness tour too, just randomly doing nice stuff, and it fits in that category, kindness.
It does.
Random act of kindness. Yeah, I mean, I'm always trying to encourage people, you know, because I know it's rough out there, and a lot of people don't get no encouragement at all. So,
nope.
If I can throw a positive word or, you know, somebody need a little change for something, whatever I got in my pocket, I should share it and give them some word of advice and just keep going, you know, just drop some seeds of inspiration. Because you never know, you know, that might be what the person need, that one little spark of inspiration or kindness that keep them living for that day. You know, they probably was thinking about taking themselves out and then God send
you
across their path.
There.
Oh, yeah. God see you cross their path to do something nice or a little gesture. And it just give them that hope that, okay, it's going to be all right. Let me survive another day. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You don't know how vital that kindness is going to be to the person that's receiving it, you know? Mm. So just do it.
Mm. Yes. Like that, I'm trying to tell you, it's huge. Yes. Just one little thing. One little thing. You don't know it, and you're not supposed to.
Right.
A lot. You're not supposed to, because it's not, you know, that's not up to you. God is creating that. Mm-hmm. You know, that cross for you to cross that path. You know, this person needs this. You just never know. I remember someone came up to me one time. I was working out, and he and I were friends. And then years had passed, and then later on, I seen him again. And then he told me that I saved his life. And it's just like, what? He's just like, you know what? During that time frame, you never knew it. And, you know, things that you were saying and the things that, you know, you helped save my life during that time with, you know, with just your words. I'm like, get out of here. You know, and it just blew my mind, because I'm like, wow, I didn't know this person was going through anything, you know? So whatever it was during that time frame, it helped him, and it helped him get out of that dark space.
Yep.
And that's why I say you have to be, you don't know what people are going through. So it's being kind, you know, that saying, I don't know if you heard it, and I have this on my one to grow onto, how can you be kind to someone you don't like? Right.
Yeah.
You know, that whole thing, there's just like, oh, it's easy to be kind to people, like, because that challenges your spirit, you know, and it's just like, you know, even if you're having a bad day, right? Mm-hmm. What's the best way to feel better?
Be kind.
It's to help someone else.
Yeah.
That's right.
That'll take your mind off.
It'll help you. Mm-hmm. Then all of a sudden you're like, why do I feel better? Why do I feel better? It's because that comes from the soul. That feeling of just being kind and giving and just loving, it comes from the soul. It comes from within. Man, I'm shaking my head. I'm shaking my head right now, because sometimes it's not always easy to be kind. I mean, we're human. We're in the flesh. And then sometimes I'm going to, you know, be real about this. Sometimes you're going to win and sometimes you won't. Somebody going to get cussed out in a road rage, probably, you know, and it's just, and then you're like, dang, but you know what? The next time you go, you know what? I'm not going to react.
Yeah, it's,
you know, you're going to win some and some of them, but just keep doing it. And then you're going to start winning more, working on that muscle of not reacting to negative energy. Mm-hmm. Right. So, but anyway, like I was saying, that the kindness, man, it just consumes a lot of the darkness. Once you start, you know, giving that kindness out, it's awesome.
Yeah, sometimes you got to be kind to yourself too. You know, we are worst critics, right?
First and foremost.
Yeah, so
you hit the nail right on the head with that one.
So practice
first and foremost.
Practice with yourself first. If it's too rough for you,
practice
on you first.
Practice with yourself first. Yep, self is first. Self love.
Yeah,
you know, self love. You know, and then start with self, and then start giving that love out. Open up those heart chakras out there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, everybody. I guess it's society set up now. Everybody's so uptight and, you know, and just short circuit and short tempered and stuff. So it's like, make some room for being kind. Yeah,
I agree. I'm all about that because that, you know, all this stuff was in COVID during that time frame. And it got people even more uptight than they were before, people on edge, rightfully so. But then, you know, when the COVID was started to fade a little bit, we kept that trauma.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Even if we didn't get sick, we were affected by everyone, our loved ones, our friends that got sick or passed away. Mm-hmm. I had several loved ones pass away during that time frame.
Yes, I think. I think everybody knew somebody that passed away.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's, you know, it's tough. So that trauma is still inside of us because we haven't dealt with it. Mm-hmm. It's not going to go nowhere.
Yep.
You know, trauma doesn't go anywhere until you deal with it. And then it can start to leave out of your spirit, you know, especially if you're, you know, an angry person or whatever it is, it doesn't matter. Whatever trauma you have inside of it, it's coming out. Mm-hmm. It's going to project somehow. And most people, it projects in a negative way. Well, so little kindness will help everybody.
Well, I was an essential worker, so I didn't stay home like everybody else. I was I was out there amongst the people that was out there. Well, most of them was just at the house. And my job, I get to pass by all these houses. So I was like this, one of the main attractions of the day because it's like, hey, look, it's a human being outside.
Right?
I'm waving, blowing horns and stuff. Hey, what's happening? And so I became like a hood hero.
Wow.
Because of my attitude.
That had to be an experience.
Yeah, it was. It was. But it was nice seeing no traffic on the freeways. That was like a ghost town.
What? Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Wow. I'm telling you, I told everybody, if you did not drive during COVID here in L.A., then you missed out. I was everywhere.
Yeah.
Getting to the airport in 15 minutes.
It was like
doing
a movie.
Traveling. Yes. I was traveling. I was doing everywhere. I was just like, this is perfect. There's no one in here.
Much as I hate traffic. After so many days of not seeing traffic, I was like, God, just let the traffic come back. Because that means people are more, you know, people are living and back to life and stuff. Because it was kind of crazy
right.
for a minute. Yeah,
it was
weird. But, you know.
Whoa.
Had to keep going. But
yeah.
Now that the traffic's back, mm-hmm. I mean, everybody's still, they back to action and living and trying to provide.
Things moving.
Yeah, but, then, mm-hmm. you know, some of them still mad as hell.
Yeah, I'm telling you, the traffic will test you. Let me tell you. It tests me every time I get in a car. It's just like, okay.
Yeah,
I test everything.
I just listen to motivation.
Yeah, but
some nice music and some motivation on Spotify or something, you know.
Yeah.
I get through it. Well, I'm sitting
that
there,
helps.
I'm sitting there plotting on some other positive stuff to do.
Thinking about your next positive move.
Yeah.
That helps move the energy.
Yeah.
You know, you have to move the energy.
Nothing you can do is just sit there and just go with the flow.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Just go with the flow. Put on some good music. Or whatever, you know, something really easy on the ears is nice to listen to.
Or sometimes I just sit there with nothing on, just inside my own head.
The
just
quietest.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just listening to the tires roll on the freeway.
Yeah. And that's the best thing. I always say, you know, get out of your head. Don't hang out in there too long because that can be trouble too. Get in and get out. Get some ideas and then get out. You know, and then start listening to your environment more. That keeps you present.
Yeah. So
keeps you present in the moment.
Pilar, anything else you want us to know about Pilar and kindness tours? If you have them, you can tell us where could they find you on the social media.
Well, tell you, if you want to reach out to us and be on a being heard, being healed, and you want to help heal people, you know, send us an email. At kindnesstours07@gmail.com. And go check out our YouTube page at Kindness Tours and see what, you know, what we've done. And you can get a feel of what the shows are about if you don't know. If you want to, you know, trying to make a decision to come on one of the shows. And you can also go to our website, kindnesstours.com. These are the places you can find us, and I will be looking forward to hearing from you all.
Cool. So look, this is the part of the show where I have my guests leave some positive life nuggets. What you got for us?
Positive life nuggets. Oh,
some inspiration or something. Hey, we'll take a couple of them. Somebody need to hear it.
Oh man. So, you know, the main thing that I would say today is just when it comes to healing is forgive yourself first. Forgive yourself. Mm-hmm. Let's start there. I did a one to grow on forgiveness a few days ago. Forgive yourself and others and you will have great times.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a challenge for some people, but forgiving yourself, that's one aspect of it. But when to forgive another that's wrong you and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
The forgiveness actually helps you. Does nothing to the other person, but it helps you to move on and live. Because if you're not forgiving another person for whatever, you're the one suffering. That person moved on with their life and going about their business, and you're the one sitting there.
That's right.
Stewing in that unforgiveness,
And yes. Then, yes.
Yeah, the forgiveness is for you.
It is. It is. It's very, you know, and like I say, start with self first, because we don't even realize that we haven't forgiven ourselves for some things. We don't even realize it. And, you know, you got to start from some self and just forgive yourself for whatever it is, and then work your way outward, you know, and that transformation happens to forgive. You'll know it.
Cool. So, yeah, that's Pilar and the Kindness Tour Lady.
Yes.
So, yeah, if you don't have anything else to share with us, we'd like to thank you for coming on the Nathaniel Noble Jr. podcast. It's been a plum pleasing pleasure.
Yes. Thank you, Nate. Thank you so much for inviting me. You know, it's awesome. And I appreciate you, and I appreciate the energy you put in with Kindness Tours as well. I'm grateful. Thank you.
You're welcome.
You've heard it exclusively on Nathaniel Noble Jr. podcast.
This is Pilar from Kindness Tours, and you're listening to Nathaniel Noble Jr. podcast. Be sure to check us out on our YouTube channel, Kindness Tours LLC. We'll be looking for you.
Gotta submit. You gotta submit. Gotta submit.
Thanks for listening to the Nathaniel Noble Jr. podcast. If you've enjoyed our show, make sure you subscribe and share with your friends. We appreciate every one of you.
Nathaniel Noble Jr. podcast.
You gotta submit.